Hey, what's up guys, welcome back to the next video of the series Node.js for Complete Beginners. So in the previous video we saw a brief explanation of Node.js and how it is used, where it is used and all that stuff, which is very important before starting any new language. So if you haven't seen that, you can check that out first. So starting with this one, we'll see a bunch of things here as well. We'll first see how to install Node and run a basic Node application. So first, for the installation, head over to your browser and search for Node.js. Click on the first link here, and here the latest version of Node available now is 8.9.4, which is recommended, and it may change depending upon when you are watching this video. So just download this. It's a really small file, I guess like 12 or 13 MB. So I have already downloaded the file, so I'll just cancel this. So after the file is downloaded, just double click on it. It's a really simple process of installation. Just next, agree the terms, and click on install. So now it is going to install it. Now the installation is complete. So if you will search for Node.js, you can find that Node is installed. Now before starting the code, I want to show you something else. Just head over to program files, Node.js folder, where it has been installed. And here you can see a node.exe file. So if you double click on it, you will see this node shell open. So this is a node environment. So here you can type a JavaScript code and it will actually work. Like if I'll do 4 plus 4, it will output me 8. 6 minus 2 is 4. I can also declare variables. So if I do var x equals 10 and hit enter, it will show undefined because I am not returning any value. But if I just type x and hit enter, you will see the value of x is displayed. I can also do x plus 1, so it is going to increment the value. Apart from variables, we can also create objects. So if I do var date equals new date and hit enter, and then just type date, you will see that it is going to display the date. So this is just to show that Node.js can work on console. So now I'll just open the command prompt. Also, if you'll type node here, you will get the same environment. So now I'll just create a folder where we'll be working. Now in Node.js, there is something called as package.json file. Now this file is important because it contains the information about your app, the entry point from where your app starts its execution. So it's important to create a package.json file for every Node app which you are going to build. Now there are two ways of creating it. One is manually typing the JSON file, which I don't prefer, and I don't think anyone will prefer, because the second method is quite easy. So I'll just navigate to the folder now, and to create the package.json file, we have to just type npm init. So it will initialize the package.json file. Now it's going to ask us a bunch of stuff. First is the package name. So if you don't type anything, the default value which is present in the parenthesis will be accepted. And one more thing, you cannot use any capital letters. So if I'll just type testing with a capital T, you can see it is saying that it cannot contain capital letters, so you have to take care of that. You cannot use any capital letters. So let's start again. So by default, the package name is the folder name, so it cannot contain spaces as well. So don't try to create a folder which has space in it, just avoid spaces. So if I just hit enter, it is going to take the value test node. Now version you can change, but by default it is going to take 1.0.0. Description you can give anything, I'll just give testing node app. Entry point, now this is important because your node app will start working by this first JS file. So by default it is index.js, and but I'll just change it to main.js. You can give anything. People usually give app.js, main.js, server.js, but then again you can choose any name. Next, we don't need this. Next, author, give your name, license, ISE, okay. So hit enter. So now it's just going to ask if it's okay, and we'll just hit enter, and it's going to create the package.json file. So now if I'll just open it with a text editor, you will see this JSON file, which is just the data which we have entered in the npm init. This is our entry point, main.js. So now we'll create that file main.js. So create a file main.js and open it with your text editor. I'm using Sublime Text, but you can use anything. So I'll just console.log any text, suppose hello world. So to start a node application, head over to your command prompt and type node main.js. So there it is, you can see the message hello world. So this is how you are going to run your node app, by the command node followed by the JS file. So I hope you have got an overall idea how to run a node.js file. So let's start coding with the first node.js app. So first we are going to create a variable. Now you can use var as well, but I'm using const because I want to keep this modern. And the reason why I'm using const is because we are not going to change these values, so it is better to keep them as const. So const http require http. Now consider PHP language. There you create a PHP file and upload it to your server, let's say Apache. Then Apache handles the request and responses for that file. But in Node.js, the case is little different. You have to create your own server. So here the code which we are going to do is creating the server, and then we'll pass a file, any simple HTML file, and we'll see if that works or not. So after requiring HTTP, next we'll create two more variables for host, which will be localhost, and a variable for port, which we can give any port. I'll just give 8000. So next I'll create a variable server, which is going to create the server. So it is going to be HTTP, the object of HTTP dot create server. Now it is going to take a callback function. So you can either use this function callback, or I'll just use a arrow function, something like this. And this will take two parameters. One is request and next is response. So first we want to set the status code of the server. Now 200 is the status code for the server to be okay. So we'll do res.statuscode equals 200. Next we want to set the header. Now header has many attributes, but we are going to use content type. And we will set that to text slash plain. It is going to parse all the contents that we throw in a form of plain text. And at the end, we will just end it with res.end. To start the server, we want it to listen to a particular port, which is the port which we have declared above. So we'll do this server.listen. And it is going to take three parameters. First is the port. Second is the host, which is the local host, and third is a callback function. So we can just console log so that we can check if the server is running or not. So I'll just write server started at port, and then we'll concatenate the port variable with it. So now if you'll open the command prompt and type node main.js, you will see the message server started at port 8000, and you will see the cursor blinking here, which means that the server is running now. So open your browser now and head over to localhost colon 8000, which is our port. Now you won't see anything because we haven't passed anything to it yet. So just for testing, at res.end we'll pass a string hello world and check what happens. Now if you'll directly refresh, you won't see anything. I purposely did that to show you, because now we have to first stop the server and then again start it. So just head over to command prompt and stop the server by just double clicking Ctrl C and start the server again. So now if you'll refresh, you will see the message hello world. So the server is running perfectly fine. Now what I did was a really basic thing, and you are not going to probably do that when you will be building an app that is passing a simple string in a res.end. We want to actually load files on a server. So to do that, we have something called as file system in Node. So I'll just create one more variable, const fs require fs, which is file system. Now one more thing I want to say here is that now the reason why I'm directly using this module is because these are core modules which are already present in Node. But if you are using some other modules like Express or socket.io or anything like that, then you need to install that first as a dependency. But as this HTTP file system, these are our core modules, we don't have to actually install it from the npm command. So let's move ahead. Next, we are going to take this fs and we are going to call a function read file, which is going to do exactly the same thing. It is going to read the file and will pass a file which will be index.html, and second parameter will be a callback function which is going to take two parameters, one for error and second is the file which is going to point to this index.html. Obviously you can give any name, file, html, I'll just give it file. And next I'll just cut this thing and paste it inside this callback function. Okay, I'll just properly indent the code. Okay, so now let's just get rid of this hello world from res.end. So now we have to create that index.html file. So create a new file with the name index.html and open it with your text editor. So I'll not be creating any app in this video. So I'll just create a basic skeleton and change the title maybe. And between the h1 tags, we'll just write the string hello world. So now in our main.js file, we can also check if there is an error or not and we can handle it. So we can just do if error is present, then I'll just throw error, but you may use some other methods of handling the errors. This part totally depends upon you. How do you want to handle the errors? Now for the file to be loaded on the browser, we are going to use this res.write function and we'll pass this file parameter, which is actually referring to index.html. So now let's start the server back and refresh. So here you can see that we are actually getting the whole skeleton structure of HTML, which is because we have set the header to text/plain. So it doesn't know that if he wants to pass this text as a text, as a HTML, as a JavaScript and whatnot. So we have to actually mention it to the server. So head back to the text editor and here just change it from text/plain to text/HTML. So again, stop the server, restart it back. And if you'll refresh now, there it is. You can see the text hello world wrapped between the h1 tags. So this is basically how you are going to start with the Node.js application by creating a server. And we have also seen how to actually load a file in a Node.js app. So now you can create any application, whatever you want. So this is just a basic knowledge. I know you might be thinking that after watching such a big video, we just saw a hello world on the screen. But don't see it like that. Before starting any language, it's necessary to go with the basics. And these are the basic things that you must know before starting Node.js. So yeah, I hope it wasn't that boring session and you might have learned something new. So that's it for today, and next we might be seeing some of the popular modules of Node. I'm actually thinking of starting with MongoDB. So for starting, we will just see the basics of all these modules, and After we have seen the basics, we will start with building real life projects, which will be more interesting. But then again, if you want to start a project, you must know the basics of any language. So if you are still seeing this button red, which means that you haven't subscribed to my channel, so consider subscribing if you want to see more tutorials like this in future. And that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed the video, and give it a like if you did. And I'll see you next time. Bye bye.